Cowboys.
Dawn in Bristol, and 27 teams of bin men get ready to gather the city's rubbish.
If I'm nice to you today, I apologise. I'll get back to normal tomorrow.
Some bin rounds are more coveted than others. And bottom of the pile are the streets of Totterdown.
They call these narrow-bodied. But there's all the narrow bits. There's all the challenge on taking us. Can't let it get to you.
Maurice Gillam has been driver here for 7 years.
If you can see daylight, you can get through. I know the loaners do help you through sometimes, but you can't always... They're watching you one side and they're waving you through, but I'm trying to tell them I can't get through on the other side.
As the boss, it helps to have been there, done that.
It's just knowing the width of your vehicle. You look at it and you can just visualise it, and I don't know what it is, it just locks in your head, that vehicle will go through there, and you go through it. And sometimes you go through there at quite a good speed as well, and you don't hit nothing, which is nice. I mean, the worst thing is if you get down a narrow road, then when you get to the end, someone's parked badly and you can't get out of the road. Then you've got to reverse all the way back. Remember, you've only got inch clearance either side. You try taking a refuse truck backwards.
So it's harder to reverse out than it is to drive in, because basically I'm crap at reversing. So they say. I don't think so, but the lads think so. But they're not driving, are they?
Across town, the Hill household has a tricky blockage of its own. But brothers-in-arms Gary and Richard Skuse are on the case.
All right, Derek. I'll get a clench for it.
Every time we press the chain, it just kept on coming up. Horrible. She went for a pop. She went for a pop then.
Well, no, she did. She did.
No, you did, Clay.
She sounds rude.
Lady's reported a blocked toilet. Obviously, we've come here. She's had a clip-on air fresheners that gets on the side of the toilet. That's apparently gone down, allegedly. If he's in the back of the toilet, you've got to try and get with your hand, with your glove on, trying to get it out. Or if it's, for God forbid, if it's down here, then, well, we'll come to that. Yeah, cross that bridge.
Right.
Push him towards the wall, right? And then pull out.
No, he's not actually in the toilet.
He should be just there. You got to be.
Right.
Let's see if we can get out of the back garden in a minute.
Right, I flushed the toilet last night and it just come up. So my partner tried to unblock it and it didn't unblock. So I phoned council this morning and they said the sun's coming out. So, but there's always blocking that toilet, so I didn't know what's wrong with it. You can't stop kids using the toilet, can you? It's been murder. I've held mine in. I'm quite lucky I haven't gone not yet, but needs to go.
Very rarely you get anybody polite is move, I'll punch your face in, what are you doing up here? That thing shouldn't be coming up here. What are you doing in a vehicle that size up here? I'm late for work, that's a favourite. I'm late for work, get out of my way. I pay your wages, that's a good one. That's a favourite. Oh, just walk away. Oh, I hate driving. I only do it for the money. And as a service to the people of Bristol.
Gary's found the right place to rob the pipe, but whoever fitted it seems to have cut a few corners.
They should have put a cap on here, an access plate, so we can get up there and down there, but we've got nothing. In my little blue thing, there's that hammer in there. Get you, all right?
Yeah.
I'm going to smack it all in it.
Emma!
There he is there.
Yeah, can you get to it? Or do you want a bit of wire?
I want a bit of wire if I could.
All right, let me investigate.
It's one of those things that clips on the side of the toilet. The pipe works a bad job because they've put a multi-quick on, which has reduced the size of the pipe, that's why he's got stuck.
But the plumber ever put this in. They recognise what they've done anyway. Let's put it that way. Yeah, that's the trouble. Those things are deadly. I don't know why people buy them, really, to be honest. All you want is ones that go in the cistern. No trouble, then. Mr. Duck, eh? Get a plumber out now to put a new 45 on.
Gonna flush it now, okay?
That's disgusting.
All right, Richard.
James, one minute.
There. Can you go to the toilet now?
Well, I'm just
trying.
Yeah,
Bristol produces nearly 600 tonnes of rubbish per day, and this is where the rest of it goes next. It's not here for long. By tomorrow morning, it'll be rotting in a landfill in leafy Buckinghamshire.
This is a private industry now. It's not the council days where, like, you know, finished at 10, go to your second job, five on a wagon, clearing 5 tonnes. You've got 3 on a wagon now. They're tipping approximately 1,500 bins a day, working hard for what they do, and they're collecting anything from 20 to 30 tonne a day. And there's a lot of refuse to collect, so we as management are under pressure to make sure they clear that. And if they break down, I mean, we've got to get that sorted. You've got work on the ground, so there's always pressure all the time.
And talking of pressure...
All right.
The voltmeter on the vehicle is on zero. And it counted again and it won't restart. Yeah. You can't miss a truck, you can see it a mile away. Somebody said they got a car horse coming out to us next. We're all seeing cars, so that might be a new one.
But a bin lift on the back.
Well, our normal vehicle was off the road with a broken throttle cable. So we've got a spare vehicle and unfortunately he's got battery problems. And he's cut out, it won't restart.
The boss arrives to sort things out.
Just bring your magic wand, we'll give you that.
No, but I brought your cards.
Oh, playing cards. Happy families.
All right, that's brilliant.
Cheers. One quick call.
I've got a spare wheelbarrow at home.
Come on, we're all.
And it's all systems go.
It's not too soon. 30 days, yeah? We've done 2 bits so far, so it's doing quite well.
Bristol City Council maintains 31,000 rental properties. But when they are beyond repair, demolition and rebuilding is the only answer. And that can be bad news for drainman Paul Vice.
This is a job that came in last night. There's 4 properties that's got sewage coming up the gullies from behind, the gullies that take the sinks and everything. Next door, there used to be another 4 houses there. So I'm assuming that somewhere under the hardcore that's left on the demolition site, there's an inspection chamber that we can get in from and actually clear the drain, and then we'll be able to clean everything up and sort everything out for all the tenants. One way or another, today it has got to be sorted.
But finding the inspection chamber is no easy matter.
I could pick anything up here, mate. I'm trying to see if I can find a manhole cover somewhere around here. I'm only guessing it's on this line. We've got something here.
Ain't mine working today?
Flaming spanner. I thought I'd scored for a minute. Beer can.
Problems at council properties get sorted straight away. But if you're a private homeowner, it's much more complicated.
Hello, my name's Rian from Bristol City Council.
All right.
Come to investigate your drains?
Yeah, come in.
Is that okay?
Yeah, come in.
Rian has been called out by Joe Turner to a case of community constipation. The manholes in his street are rapidly filling up.
Right, basically what I want to do is just have a look in the inspection chamber. What I want to establish is who else is responsible, so that you can all, between you, get the works done.
You can see it's beginning to back up.
Yeah.
Because that shouldn't be there, should it? No.
The situation is not too bad yet at Joe's.
So it's blocked right up in yours, is it?
Yeah.
But down the hill, things are much more serious for Keith Head.
This is absolutely diabolical. Mm, I think there's 10 houses on this.
Yeah.
There's a six down the side and the four at the bottom.
No. So what we need to do is get us all coordinated between us. If we can get it all done informally, that's better. Yeah. But otherwise, I can force everyone to do
it. As residents, all we're concerned about is not having this problem.
Rian could get the drain unblocked herself, but guess what? It would take longer and cost more. Whereas the residents could organise an immediate repair for under a tenner each.
If you can come round with me when we knock the other people's doors and then hopefully we get it all sorted together, it'll make everyone's lives a little bit easier. Right.
Back at the demolition site, Paul still hasn't found his manhole.
Get us some gloves, Mike, and a couple of screwdrivers. Oh! There's a drain cover under here, which looks as if it could be it. But could be stormwater there. Oh! That's two on the trot. It's definitely stormed that. I can smell it perfect. God, I love this job. Try another planter attack. Oh. There's got to be another one somewhere, mate. Yeah, yeah. See, even he's full, that one. Not as bad. Go upwards, mate. Go upwards. Get up the one way and go the other. It's all night anyway. Can you just see anything under there, Rich?
Hang on. Have you had this one out? It's one here.
No.
It's one here and there.
I don't know.
Screwdrivers
in here. Can you see the one we just had up?
Yeah, it's still got snails on. It can't be the one that we just had up.
Oh, yes, Rich.
Is he full, yeah?
He's full, mate.
Try checking from there, then.
I'm a fool to do your dirty work. Oh, yeah.
And then, because of what I'm saying, because I can't actually do anything.
Try to find out who you can get to clear a blocked drain.
I'm not admitting liability.
No, no, I'm not admitting liability. But...
We'll pay.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
But you know where we're coming from, Rosie.
Yes,
you can see the problem.
I do.
Everything's going to plan.
We're talking about 10 houses splitting the cost.
But there's still the question of who'll pick up the phone and collect the cash.
What I'm thinking now is, because we've got so many of you to agree anyway, if you want to get the contractors out to you as soon as possible...
Well, can you get them out for us?
Well, ideally, I can't act in that capacity. So.
Rianne, we have an immediate problem with a blocked drain. What we want is it cleared. Surely we can get that done and get it sorted out after.
Well, yeah, but...
You've heard that most people are willing to sort it out.
As an employee of the council, I cannot go around collecting money off people.
So the council don't do it anymore?
What?
It used to.
Yeah?
Years ago. Mm.
Right, supposing I walked indoors now and said, you know, I'm going indoors, sorry, good night, and shut the door, because I'm not blocked at the moment, what would you do? You've got people who can't go to the toilet from 8, 9, 10, 11.
Well,
would you do?
I would go to the... I'd have to go back, get the notices and serve notices and allow the 48 hours to expire, as we explained earlier.
Right.
So that's the only legal powers I've got. But
have you powers to actually get the drain cleared?
Yeah, but I got to give 48 hours notice.
48 hours?
I can only work within the legislation I'm provided with. Because at the end of the day, if I put a notice in through your door, you were away for the day... And I decided to do the works in default, and then I charge you for all of this and that. You would then say to me, well, why didn't you give me notice?
Right.
So you've got to look at it from two points of view.
Can we assume that the 48 hours is up and you can press on and get it done?
No, because I haven't seen the notice yet.
This is a joke.
What we need to do is coordinate between you all to get it sorted, and that would make it easier. But I can't do it. I can't ask people for money, and I can't go around saying, right, you've got to pay £9, you've got to pay this amount, because that's not my job.
You've got to be pretty solid. What's in there, mate? Whack him on! light on it here on the blockage. See him? Stopped again. I come to a dead end. Whatever's in there, we've still got to find that manhole at the other end. Something not right here.
Rian's not quite at a dead end, but she's getting close, and Joe's left her to it.
Surely there's just one person that's at fault.
No. And if we leave it any longer, you're not going to be able to use your toilet, your bath, your sink, or anything. Do you accept that you will contribute towards the cost of having it unblocked?
Yeah.
All right, thanks ever so much. Just sorry just to turn up on your doorstep.
That's all right.
All right, cheers. Bye. It certainly is frustrating, you know, because you're trying to deal with certain people and some are very nice and approachable and some other people just want to argue the toss with you. It would be easier for me if, say, I went back to the office, served notice on the mall, sat in the office, waited 48 hours to expire. I'd be nice and warm by now and it would all be sorted. But because I'm a nicer person than that, I'm going to try and persist. It's just costing me my little freezing cold toes. Right, let's go.
From this cover, about 39 metres.
39 metres of hose went down the drain before it stopped. So the blockage should now be easy to find.
Definitely somewhere here. We found two manholes here. The reason we couldn't find them with a metal detector is because there's no lids on them. Which doesn't help a lot, does it, when you've got a metal detector trying to find no metal? Obviously, when this site's been reclaimed, the lids have come off and it's now full. Hopefully, it's not too deep. If it's not, we can just get it out by hand. It should only be about a metre and a half deep, I think, all being well.
Everyone's agreed to pay now, but still no one's volunteered to make the call.
I wouldn't even let my daughter bring my grandchildren over here because I know they can't use the toilet. I thought Joe was going to do all this. Go around each one and say to them, you know, let's all pay so much to it.
I've come to the end of the list now, so unless something is sorted, by the time I leave this street today, I'm going to serve a notice on people, right? So if somebody will just volunteer to do it, right, and I'm not saying that you have to, but nobody's done it so far.
Two hours digging.
All right, chicken.
Still no sign of the bottom.
This isn't a run-of-the-mill job. It's unusual. But at the end of the day, we've got to get through it. Look at the lumps of fat there coming out there. That's all fat and grease, that is. See it? It's just set hard. Time for out. The sewage is coming through now from upstream. Yeah. Right, I gotta get back down here now, guys. Excuse me. Look at this. I'm sure I should have had longer gloves. Look. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Not one of the best jobs, not one of the easiest, definitely not one of the cleanest. But at the end of the day, there's four families up here who's going to be well chuffed tonight. That's what makes a job worthwhile. That'll do, mate. Let's go. Job done.
And there's light at the end of the tunnel for Rian. The loss of his loo has proved too much for Keith.
Good afternoon. I'm ringing to see if we can have somebody out to unblock our drains.
Believe it or not, I thought this would be easier. The easier option.
Somebody's got to do it, so I may as well do it. And as long as they know that how much they've got to pay, I can't see a problem if they've already agreed to do it.
I should go round with my drainage rods in the back of my car. So then when things like this happen, I can just say to you, all right, then I'll tell you what.
Give me 90 quid.
Give me 90 quid, right? I'll put my waders on, I get my rods out, and I'll rod you through.
And sure enough, in a fine example of all that makes Britain great...
What's happening now?
Joe and his mate Dave have saved the day.
We put the drain rods up and then it freed when it was here somewhere.
So if we lift that now and we see if that's clearing. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, it's gone. It's gone. Here, you thank that fella there because he's done it.
Yeah.
Him, Dave.
Right.
He got his rods out.
So what did you do? You rodded that down there.
And then it freed it. And then it went.
Oh, brilliant.
Loose come down.
Okay then. Okay. Thanks ever so much.
That's
cheers.
All right. No problem. Thank you. Thanks for the help.
Yeah. Right. Thank you.
Bye then. Bye.
Well, actually, all my efforts of the day have gone completely down the chute. Because all it needed was somebody to go and rod the drains, which I would have done if it was in my street anyway. I think I'm mentally fatigued. So, yeah, I'll just go home and cuddle up with Bam Bam on the sofa, my little puppy dog. I want to go to the toilet, but I didn't want to ask anyone to go to the toilet. Yes, I think to my-